Hello everyone, my name is Yu Liang. I come from City University of Hong Kong. Today I'm going to introduce our work, CacheSifter. It aims to improve both flash storage lifetime and system performance by reducing unnecessary writes of cache files. First, let me quickly go over the summary of this work. The problem is that unnecessary writes could reduce flash storage lifetime because flash chips have limited write cycles, also known as PE cycle. Moreover, unnecessary writes could also decrease system performance because of increased I/O contention. We find that a large percentage of writes is contributed by cache files. To improve re-access performance, Android systems temporarily store all the cache files in mobile devices to avoid re-download overhead. However, we find that not all cache files need to be stored persistently, so some of them do not need to be written back to flash storage. The goal of this paper is to improve both flash storage lifetime and system performance. The key idea of this work, CacheSifter, is to differentiate cache files and treat them according to their reuse behaviors and memory storage usage. Our evaluation results show that CacheSifter can reduce writes more than 60% and thus can much prolong the flash lifetime and improve system performance. I think everyone has a smartphone, probably more than one. Do you know how much data would be written into your smartphone each day? According to our survey and our cooperative vendors data, the total writes data each day is about 10 gigabytes on average and up to 30 gigabytes. The write data are not that much in previous. The number is increased quickly recent years with the growing usage of applications and the continual increased network speed. As we know, writes could reduce flash storage lifetime and system performance. The problem could be more severe in the future because of faster network and newer flash chips, such as TLC, QLC, and 3D NAND flash, which with shorter endurance. We found that a large percentage of writes is contributed by cache files. We evaluated the write size and write numbers of 20 commonly used applications. Our volunteers use each application for 2 hours. We break down all the writes produced by these applications to cache files and others. First, let's see the write size. We can see write size varies by application. Write size of cache files can be up to 3.5 gigabytes within 2 hours. Cache file writes represents an average of 64% of total writes. Thus, according to our survey and our cooperative vendors' data, cache file writes could be 6.4 gigabytes on average and up to 19.2 gigabytes each day. This so many writes could greatly hurt lifetime of flash storage. Similarly, write number also varies by application. According to our evaluation, write number could be 1.7 million per 2 hours. This writes could produce many IO operations and thus could degrade system performance, especially under extensive IO workloads. Mobile applications usually request lots of data from network. To improve re-access performance, Android system cache all this data in memory and then write them back to the flash storage. It not only reduces the flash storage lifetime, but also degrades the I/O performance. To solve this problem, some related works propose to store cache data in the main memory. This method can fasten re-access and also reduce writes to flash storage if the memory is sufficient. However, the memory is limited in practice. Our workshop paper proposed to handle cache files differently according to their characteristics, but still requires a solution. In this work, we proposed a solution to do that. Some data are downloaded from networks. Android system first caches them in DRAM and then read them to the flash storage. The cache data are called cache files. We find that cache files are not all the same. Specifically, they have different reuse behaviors. Some of them just get read once and not used again. Some of them will be reused many times in a short period of time. Others could be reused after a long time. Thus, we categorize cache files into three types and handle them differently. The file only read once and not reused again, we call them BAR files. The file will be frequently reused in a short period of time, we call them transient files. The file that could be reused after a long time, we call them long-living files. They cannot benefit from DRAM's low latency. BAR files do not need to be stored. Transient files should be cached in DRAM so they can obtain the benefit from low reaccess latency, while long-living files are better to be stored in the flash storage to reduce the transfer over the network. Here is the goal of CacheSifter. We need to categorize files into three types. This operation should be fast and application transparent. And then we need to manage cache files based on their types. The goal is to maximize DRAM utility, especially when there are multiple applications. Moreover, CacheSifter should adapt to changes in user behaviors. It will recategorize the files as needed. Finally, CacheSifter should ensure safety when deleting cache files. All newly downloaded cache files are first maintained in the main memory and wait for categorization. CacheSifter adopts a lightweight machine learning-based categorization engine to divide these cache files into three types, BAR, transient, and long-living. To better utilize memory and storage, CacheSifter discards all BAR files because they are typically not reused. The deleted file will be redownloaded from the network when they are reaccessed in the future, which provides an opportunity to change the categorization of cache files according to the changes in user behavior. For transient files, CacheSifter keeps them in DRAM by using an in-memory file system, which is designed to avoid an accidental swap out of transient files. CacheSifter discards transient files when there is insufficient DRAM space by using an LIU-like file eviction policy. Transient files will be reaccessed from memory before they are deleted. They will be redownloaded from the network when they are accessed after delete. For long-living files, CacheSifter writes them to the flash storage by exploiting the default LIU-based eviction scheme of Android systems. Long-living files can be reaccessed from flash storage. Finally, CacheSifter exploits a safe list mechanism to maintain known potential paths of cache files that are important to users, or in case their deletion could threaten system stability. Here is our experimental setup. We implement and evaluate CacheSifter on two real smartphones, Huawei P9 and Mate 30. The baseline is default Android systems. We compare two machine learning categorization models, high accuracy and high recall models. The high accuracy model treats all types with the same priority, while the high recall model attempts to minimize some inaccurate categorization to reduce the redownload penalty. Here's evaluation results for cache file rate reduction. We take a high recall model on smartphone P9 as an example. X-axis is running applications. The first 10 is using only one application. The others mean that there is a bunch of applications. We use the first two letters to identify the application's name. This represents the combination of Chrome, Facebook, and TikTok. Y-axis is the reduction ratio. This number is made by CacheSifter rise divided by baseline rise. We evaluate the IO number reduction and the write amount reduction of cache files and total writes. First, let's see size reduction of total writes and cache file writes. Cache file writes reduction is usually larger than 60%. However, the total writes reduction varies by applications. There are two reasons. First, cache ratio varies by application. Cache ratio is 95% for Facebook. However, it's only 43% for Map. The second reason is variation between different types. For example, Candy Crush as a standalone game, it usually produces small cache files, but here the ratio is up to 72%. Because there are some variation between different types when using real applications. We try to replay trees to eliminate this variation. However, we cannot obtain precise trees because there are lots of information need to be collected at the same time. Therefore, we still choose to use real applications for evaluation. And we conduct many operations to make fair comparison. More details, please check our paper. From these results, the total rise is reduced by 53% on average. Thus, flash lifetime can be much prolonged. According to the previous works, the lifetime is inversely proportional to the total rise. Total write IO can be reduced by 48% on average. Thus, system performance can be much improved due to the reduction on IO contention, especially under extensive IO workloads. Okay, now let's analyze the overhead of CacheSifter. Since CacheSifter delays some cache files, it may introduce extra network overhead because of misclassification. There are six types of misclassification, but only three of them could lead to redownload. When consent file is categorized into BAR file, or long-living file is categorized into BAR or transient files. If put a long-living file into transient type, it will stay in main memory for a while, and thus this case has a small possibility to redownload. Thus, we call it a lower bound of network overhead, and the other case are upper bound. Thus, we evaluated the upper bound and the lower bound for two models. As shown in figure, the upper bound of either model is smaller than 10%. The memory overhead includes three parts for categorization, for maintaining transient files, and for machine learning inference. The total memory usage is 12.5 megabytes. Since the training and retraining part is conducted on PC, the overhead on smartphones is trivial. It includes two parts. The total CPU time is 84 milliseconds out of 10 seconds. Finally, let me quickly summarize this work. The problem is that unnecessary writes could reduce flash storage lifetime and system performance. We find that a large percentage writes is contributed by cache files. to improve RISC-V performance. Android systems temporarily store all the cache files in mobile devices to avoid the download overhead. However, we find that not all cache files need to be written back to the flash storage. The goal of this work is to improve both the flash storage lifetime and the system performance. The key idea of this work is to differentiate cache files and treat them according to their reuse behaviors. Our evaluation results show that a CacheSifter can reduce RISC more than 60% and thus can much prolong flash lifetime and improve system performance. Okay, that's all. Thank you for listening. Any questions, please feel free to contact us. Moreover, the source code is released. The link can be found in our paper. Thank you very much.